In this video, we'll show you three different workouts. One push-based, for chest and triceps. One pull-based, back and biceps. And a leg day, focusing on quads. Using supersets for maximum intensity and an advanced stretching technique to create maximum muscle growth.
Starting with push day, hitting chest and triceps. This chest workout starts with a big compound movement, flat bench barbell press. Go as heavy as possible, getting the whole chest fired up and pre-exhausting the muscles, ready for the rest of the workout. Now, let's build the intensity with a superset, starting with standing cable flies. Full range of movement. Think of it like a giant bear hug, stretching, then squeezing the muscle fibers. High reps, keep up the pace, pumping blood into the muscle and keeping it there for the second part of the superset. Now, straight into standing cable chest press. Squeeze the handles together to keep maximum contraction in the chest. This is about creating time under tension. Think of this as one continuous movement, squeezing the whole time. As you do, you'll feel the tension shift through different parts of the chest. Next, decline dumbbell fly. Same principle as before, just hitting a different angle. So, high reps, steady pace, stretch, and squeeze. Let's keep it going with another superset now. It's an incline dumbbell press. The incline means you've now hit all the angles on the chest. As before, we're combining fly movements with pressing movements, the stretch and the squeeze. So now a standing hold for 30 seconds. This will really stretch the fascia, the tissue that covers the muscle, allowing more muscle growth.
Time to hit triceps.
Using the machine. Just one set, but go right to failure. Finally, tricep extension with dumbbells on a decline bench. Three sets of 12 reps. Elbows high to put maximum tension on the long head of the tricep. Adding a twist will help you get a full squeeze on the muscle. Now, a bonus exercise for abs, hanging leg raises. Why are we doing abs on push day? Because the hanging position also engages your chest. Toes to bar, contracting the whole of your upper body. An exercise like this will help thicken the muscles, creating deeper cuts. So, that's your push day workout for chest, triceps, and abs. So, day two of this 3-day split is pull day, back and biceps.
Using supersets for maximum intensity.
and stretching during the workout, not afterwards.
Starting with body weight pull-ups, that big compound movement.
Firing up all the back muscles, ready for the rest of the session. Going to failure on this first exercise. When you hit failure, take a rest and go again. Notice how your biceps are also being used in this exercise. One of the reasons we're pairing back and biceps in this workout. Going again to failure. Next, wide grip lat pulldown. Overhand grip. Nice and wide. Full range of motion with a weight you can control. Now move to narrow grip, about shoulder width apart, for one more set. Hitting the back muscles from that different angle. Next, changing the pace with a single arm lat pull down. Using one arm at a time allows a much greater range of movement. Again, hitting a different angle. Really stretch at the top, squeeze at the bottom. Two sets on each side. Rotate the hand as you go up for maximum stretch. Moving on now to a superset. Starting with a straight arm pull down. Using a superset to pump blood into the muscles across both exercises. So this is high reps, keeping up the pace. Supersetting on the same machine, this time kneeling. Again, an angle you've not hit before. For this exercise, move the bar in a kind of J shape. Pull the bar into the body as you press the chest up and arch your back. This is a deep contraction that will bring the squeeze right into the lower part of the back. Next, T-bar row, to thicken the muscles in the middle of your back. Straight back, keep the hips low, linebacker stance. Using smaller plates lets you stretch down further than you would with a larger plate. It's all about the stretch and the squeeze. Still some angles you haven't worked, so now it's single arm dumbbell row, three sets. Setting the bench to incline, hitting the muscles from yet another angle. And finally, for back. You're going to stretch out the lat muscles to help them grow later. Start with this cable pull, working through the full range of movement. Again, adding a twist for a full squeeze. Then, on the last rep, hold. Keeping the load on the muscle, this is a great stretch for the tissue that sits above the muscle, known as the fascia. Working both sides, you'll feel the lactic acid building up. It's probably gonna hurt, but it also helps promote muscle building. Now, bicep curls. You've been using your biceps on most of these pulling and rowing movements. Now, target them directly. Using an incline bench and a hammer hold, hitting the biceps in a way they weren't used in the back workout. Leaning back helps you stretch the long head of the bicep to build a fuller muscle. Finally, a standing cable curl. Overhand grip brings in the forearms, which you haven't targeted so far in this workout. Shoulders back, bring the bar up, and hold. So, that's your pull workout, back and biceps. So now the third session of this 3-day split, the one that everybody loves, leg day. Today, it's quads. Starting off with a heavy compound movement, barbell squats. 2 sets of just 5 reps. Heavy as possible to get the whole body fired up. Blood pumping into the quads. Take a good rest between the 2 sets, 2 to 3 minutes. After 2 heavy sets, take another good rest. Then reduce the weight and go again. Now it's lower weight, more reps. Six sets of 12. Full range of motion and shorter rest periods in between. Next, a superset. Starting with the narrow stance machine press. Go as deep as you can. Foot placement is about hip width apart for that outer quad sweep. Then, straight into the dumbbell lunge. Going from fixed movement on the machine to free movement with the dumbbells. Torso upright, front leg to 90 degrees. Don't let the knee hit the floor. Next, over to the Smith machine for 3 different exercises. Keeping the momentum, it's a tri-set, starting with front squat. Using a front grip to keep the emphasis on the quads. This machine gives you added stability, so you can go deeper on the movement. After 10 reps, straight into a sissy squat. You may have tried these on a machine that locks your feet, but here, the stability comes from the Smith machine. And holding on gives you more control. Then, straight into the third element of the tri-set. This is a Cossack lunge. Again, using the machine to stabilize, this movement activates different parts of the leg that haven't been used so far. Now, leg extensions, which we're combining with a stretch. So it's 4 sets of 15 reps on the machine. Again, high reps, fast pace to keep the blood in the muscle. Then, straight into a kneeling stretch. This is working on the fascia, the tissue that sits just above the muscle. It's an intense stretch, but it'll help the muscle grow during recovery. So that's your quads workout.